Presentation on European Monetary System presented by Akhilesh K, MCOM Final, MPM Government Postgraduate College, Karkala. Introduction. The European Monetary System was the forerunner of Economic and Monetary Union, which led to the establishment of the Euro. It was a way of creating an area of currency stability throughout the European community by encouraging countries to coordinate their monetary policies. It used to exchange rate mechanism to create stable exchange rate in order to improve the trade between European Union member states and those helped the development of the single market. The European monetary system established in 1979 for the aim to create a stable exchange rate. It also encouraging country to coordinate their monetary policies. It will also improve the trade between European Union member state and main aim to the for the single market. Next is the history of the European monetary system. Beginning from the Second World War, the Bretton Woods system was issued to try and maintaining stability among major currencies. However, it was dropped in 1971. European countries then launched the European Monetary System in 1979, and leaders sought to achieve monetary stability through a stable exchange. The EMS launched the European Currency Unit and European exchange rate mechanism in order to achieve the overarching goal of monetary stability and work towards the idea of single market in Europe. It stayed in place until 1999 and was then succeeded by the European Monetary Union and the Euro. Beginning, Bretton Woods system was used to try and maintaining stability among major currencies, but it dropped in 1971. Later 1979, European country launched the European Monetary System. The main goal of European Monetary System is monetary stability and work towards the idea of a single market in Europe. Then the European Monetary Union will succeed by establishment of European Monetary System. Next is the meaning of the European Monetary System. European Monetary System refers to an arrangement established in 1979 whereby members of the European Economic Community agreed to link their currency to encourage monetary stability in Europe. The European Monetary System aimed to create a stable exchange rate for easier trade and cooperation among European countries through an exchange rate mechanism. European Monetary System, it will be established in 1979. The members of the European arrangement to link to these currencies. It main aim to the control fluctuation and stable exchange rate for the easier trade in Europe. Next is objective of the European Monetary System. The first objective is to establishment a zone of monetary stability in Europe. It means the European Monetary System, the main objective is the monetary stability in Europe and control fluctuation in their European members and Europe. Second one is to pay off the way of the European Monetary Union. In here, PEU means easy to the way to European Monetary Union. The European Monetary Union will be the control the European Monetary System. So this will be easy to European Monetary Union. Next objective is to enhance Europe's power in international affairs. It means increasing Europe's monetary system in international level. It is one of the main objective of the European Monetary Union. Fourth objective is to make Europe a unified market. It is the main objective of the European monetary system. The main objective, they make their market into like unified market. The last objective is to make Europe politically stable and peaceful. The last objective is make Europe politically stable and peaceful. Because if the fluctuation rate increase or decrease, it will be affected politically and it will be disturbed peacefulness. Therefore, European monetary system is the main aim to the politically stable and peaceful. Next is working of European monetary system. The main element of the European monetary system are, the first one is the exchange rate mechanism. The exchange rate mechanism was a system introduced by the European Economic Community in 1979. The ERM was established in order to keep the exchange rate of member countries within specified band in relation to each other, most exchange rate fixed by the European monetary system until 1993. Could fluctuation up or down between 2.25% against any currency. Next is the European currency unit. The European currency unit was a basket of the currency of the European Community member state, used as the unit of account European Community before beginning replaced by Euro. The European currency unit was introduced as unit of account by European Union on the formation of EMS in 1979. Its value was equal to an weighted average of currencies of member countries. The weight given to the each currency was according to the relative size of country, GDP and in extra community trade. Next one is the European Monetary Cooperation Fund. The European Monetary Cooperation Fund was an important part of the EMS. It was an institute and the fund established in 1973 by members of European Exchange Rate Mechanism to stabilize exchange rates. In other words, it was a fund organized by European Monetary System in which the members of European Union deposited reserve to provide to pool of resources to stabilize exchange rate and financing balance of the main support. The last one is financing facilities. The members of the European Monetary System had access to create credit facility which aimed to at helping countries with public deficit to manage their transitory problem and define their exchange rate parties. These facilitate transitory problems and define their exchange rate parties. These facility covered their very short term and medium term requirement and were operated by their central bank. Next is goal of the European monetary system. The European monetary system aimed to achieve various macroeconomic goal is the first one is encouraging trade within the Europe. It encouraging people in the Europe to trade within the Europe. And second one is exchange rate stability among trade members. Second goal will be exchange rate stability among the trading members. It will encouraging to who trade in Europe. And last one is the control inflation within the Europe. The main objective and aim of the European monetary system is to control the fluctuation rate. It will help the trade in the Europe. This is main goal of the European monetary system. Next, the crisis, the 1992 crisis. The European monetary system established a common monetary policy among member state and fixed the exchange rate. In 1992, Germany raised the interest rate to combat inflation. It placed upward pressure on exchange rate of the member countries at the time when they needed low interest rate and higher export, resulting in a crisis. Each country demonstrated different economic characteristics. Some relied on cheap labor cost, while others were export-oriented economies. The increase the interest rate resulted in a different impact of each economy. With the exchange rate fixed, many countries experienced turmoil and ultimately eliminated their pegging system with the European currency system, allowing the exchange rate to float over time. The European monetary system changed the bandwidth for exchange rate volatility from 2.25% to plus or minus 15%. The first reason to crisis, the Germany rise to interest rate in common inflation. It will be affected because when the increases the interest rate, in that time in it required a low interest rate but and higher export, but they are increasing interest rate. It will be a main reason of the crisis in 1992. The second reason is each country will be changed their own characteristics, because when they increase the interest rate, it will be affected each country. This is also one of the reason to the crisis. The third reason will be when the Europe will be fixed exchange rate, the main country will be experiencing turmoil and ultimately eliminated their pegging system with the European monetary currency. So these are main reason for the in 1992. Next is benefit of European monetary system. The first one is ensuring currency stability. The Europe monetary system ensured currency stability in Europe during the times of international market volatility. Mean different difficult times. So next one is working towards a single market. The European monetary system was considered an important step towards the establishment of the European Union and the single market in Europe. The last objective is unity in Europe. The European monetary system promoted politically and economic unit across the Europe at a time of European history. Next is drawback of the European monetary system. First one is fixed exchange rate. Fixed exchange rate affected different members of the European monetary system in different ways. Each were not beneficial to all economic. It became the evident in 1992 crisis. The last drawback is common monetary policy. The European monetary system promoted a common monetary policy. Therefore, rising or decreasing interest rate, it affected all economic differently, just like exchange rate system. Next is the end of the European monetary system. In here we can see the how the end of the European monetary system. The following event in 1998, the European monetary system was set to undergo a three-stage reform that easy to transition to a common European monetary union. The first stage introduced free capital movement across the Europe and was the part of the 1992 crisis. It continued fluctuating under the Maastricht Treaty, which was signed in 1992 and laid the foundation for the European Union. The second and third stage came in 1998 and 1999 respectively. After the introduction of the Euro, the European monetary system and its exchange rate system were replaced by the adoption of the Euro and the formation of the European Central Bank, which has authority over the European Union monetary system. This way, these are the main reason for the end of the monetary system. At finally conclusion, it generally believed that stable exchange rate between the currency of the European Community members country will encourage their economic interaction, paving the way of closer economic and political union. The success or failure of the European monetary system will ultimately depend on the willingness of European countries to sacrifice their own divergent economic objective for the sake of stable exchange rate. Thank you.